Shalom and welcome, Ras Tefi. I am Alonzo, and we are presenting from Southern California on what is this this Rastafari Fellowship channel on YouTube. Now, this is concerning whitewash. Let us share with all the lovers of truth, especially I and I brothers and sisters in Ras Tefi, in the body of Christ, some of what we've attained. Some of the evidence for the whitewashing that we have obtained, that we have now in our possession. For a while, we took this book out from the local library. Nonetheless, what is going on? Now, I'm going to go ahead and say that there is an image of Christ being whitewashed. But many would say that that is just an opinion, and they are completely correct. So let us go into the description being that is... Okay, this is the description of the image we just presented, and it reads, "The iconoclast were literally image breakers, as can be seen in the manuscript illustration at left, in which an image of Christ is being obliterated with whitewash. Which an image of Christ is being obliterated with whitewash. Only abstract decorations such as the mosaic tiles that surround a window in Hagia Sophia below escaped the iconoclast wrath." And this is indeed and in fact and in truth that image being spoken of. And this book is Hagia Sophia. You know, took it out of the, let's see, local library. And let us read from this point. And it says, "The reaction against the cult of images coincided with a period of Arab invasions of the Byzantine Empire and was indeed comparable to the Islamic prohibition of all human images. The Arab campaign of 717 culminated in a siege of Constantinople that was repelled by Leo III, called the Assyrian, thus saving the empire. On this occasion, there was no exhorting of the miraculous icon of the Virgin. There had been during the first Persian siege a century earlier, for Leo was an Asian and a man of iconoclast sympathies. He had relied for his empire's defense against the Arabs, not upon miracles, but upon the ascetic peasant soldiery of Asia Minor, many of whom ascribed corruption and idolatry within their church. Hence Leo's reformist decree, initially moderate in intent, it led, as time went by, to persecutions, the widespread destruction of works of church art, and the dissolution of secularization of monasteries." Now, just to mention the whole the mentioning of Islamic prohibition of all human images, it is interesting that this mosaic on the bottom is in fact what the Islamics do accept. And it's interesting because a mosaic is it's many different tiles, little squares that when put together, some are different colors. When they are completed, they represent an image. But the Islamic Revolution movement prohibited any human images, and it's interesting because we know that they worship a black cube, a black square, and so mosaics being composed of nothing but cubes, and thus, you know, as we can see in some of these Islamic, wherever, what they call them, without disrespecting them, you know, they're filled with geometrical patterns and figures, and that's interesting. It's not to say anything that we don't know, but, you know, they definitely don't accept a human image. Nonetheless, let us continue, and it reads, "Leo personally destroyed a figure of Christ over the gate of his palace in Constantinople. and it was later replaced with a large cross and an inscription. The emperor cannot endure, this is the inscription, the emperor cannot endure that Christ should be represented by a mute and lifeless image graven of earthly materials. But Leo and his young Constantine have at their gates engraved the thrice blessed representation of the cross, the glory of believing monarchs. So basically, that's what we have to present from this book, and let us just include. Okay, we actually just like this one, so we're gonna share that one, this picture with everyone. Yeah, that's just because we liked it. But okay, let us continue on to the second book. And the second book is the Early Christian and Byzantine World. I mean, there's many different images, but that we could go into further detail, but we're just gonna review some of the more important ones. But first, let me introduce kind of like what a mosaic is. Well, this is exactly what a mosaic is. So you can see it's made from nothing but little cubes, little squares. So we just thought that was interesting. Yeah, that one has a human image, but let us continue. Let us introduce this picture right here of Jesus Christus, of course. And now, what's interesting about this picture is that some may not be able to tell because you don't have the image like in close proximity. But it's like there's a lot of white paint being thrown on top of the images. For example, this one. These are like they have a lighter toned skin, but you could clearly tell when you close up that it's kind of like paint being thrown on top of it, but they didn't want to make it too obvious. And so, you know, you could see this was supposed to be Paul, I believe, and you can see Paul right there with like white dots of paint being thrown, like trying to kind of make them lighter. You could definitely see it in Geta Jesus's feet. They took the time to splatter some paint on them. Now let us continue. There's a few pictures or images that are interesting and that we want to share, because this is related to our next presentation, which is concerning the Epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Romans. Okay, here we go. Now, here, take a look at this image. One of the few surviving evidences for the whitewashing, and once again, we see the whitewashing taking place. And we could see Geta Jesus looking a lot more like His Majesty with the, you could tell. And it reads, "The destruction of icons," and this is the detail, you know, a little note concerning the image we've presented. "The destruction of icons, 11th century, Shaldov, Psalter. State Historical Museum, Moscow. This Psalter has marginal illustrations where the freely drawn miniatures are not in frame. Here the crucifixion is depicted with two iconoclasts to the left smearing an icon of Christ with whitewash." That's really something, right? Okay, we really hope that is visible. And if not, forgive me. The crisis, which with its dramatic ups and downs was to last for more than 100 years, caused the destruction of innumerable works of art, both in the churches and in other buildings. This explains the gap in our information on Eastern Christian art prior to the 9th century. The support given to the popes, to those bishops who were in favor of images, finally brought about a change in the policy of the church councils, which of course supported the decision of the emperors. The main source of the conflict lay in the differences between the emperors and the various candidates for the succession politics. The final reestablishment of images in 843 was the work of the wife of the Iconoclast emperor Theophilus. The empress Theodora, acting on behalf of her son Michael III, it was marked by the restoration of the image of Christ on the palace gates. I wonder if the restoration of a white Christ, of a white Antichrist, or Christ in his true Ethiopian humanity.